In our last episode, we make final preparations to leave the marina, had consultations with Precision Sails to get our new head sail in the works, and finally pulled out of Indiantown Marina and made our way to the coast of Florida as cruisers once again.
What do we do?
Kick, push, coast.
4 hours or so into our early morning. Today we left Stuart with the goal to get all the way down to Palm Beach, back to our lovely spot in Peanut Island if we can make it. But we're near the winter solstice, so we don't have many daylight hours, and we're kind of pushing ourselves. And there's a few more boaters on the water than there was last time too. Proud day for me because I usually don't like to do this. I did 2 of the bascule bridges all on my own. Because normally I hand it over to Matt. But
she doesn't like fighting currents.
I was going to say, that's the only thing, is I don't like fighting currents. And once we get down towards Jupiter and Palm Beach, they're really strong, about 2 knots. And I keep getting pushed around and that freaks me out. So that's when I just hand it over. I'll get my son, just not today.
And it is time to start Death by Bridges. We did the last 3. I think we're on demand and we like those, but now we have the bridges where they're scheduled to open on every half hour, an hour. And these are the ones that we always have the 3-knot currents trying to push us in, and we seem to get there 20 minutes early, so we're fighting it for a really long time. Not fun days. So as you can tell, I'm no longer behind the helm. Matt thinks it's fine.
Big wimp.
Nice scenery.
There is nice scenery. Lots of people about today.
Yep.
And we've got company in other boats for once. Kind of strange not being the only one around anymore. But after this bridge, we have 30 minutes to go 3 miles to the next bridge, which opens on the half hour. Because again, we don't want to get there 25 minutes early and have to wait. Trying not to hit the boat in front of us as we both wait to go through. And so we wait, and we wait, and we wait. This is where we start turning in all directions due to the current. This is why I don't drive.
Opening dance.
After making it under our first timed bridge, we still had 3 more to go before we would reach the Lake Worth area where we'd be anchoring for the night. With a decent current behind us, we thought we'd easily make the next bridge 3 miles away in our 30-minute time limit. Although we did miss that one and ended up having to slow ourselves down, we just enjoy the views instead and try to keep our pace for the remaining 2 ahead.
And away roll, just a rebel to the world with no place to go. And so we kick, push, kick, push, kick, push, kick, push, coast. So come escape with me, just a rebel looking for a place to be. So let's kick and push.
Now that we're cruising, one of the things that we forgot to do, and I was kind of excited to do it since we left, is we can finally get rid of our privacy shades. Our very high class, well constructed, just like the rest of our work.
Yeah.
But
we only had to do those one time.
We did.
Yeah.
One and done.
One and done. I think that's maybe the first thing that we did that we didn't have to redo. So the privacy shades. Now we have a nice clear view again,
and
people not looking inside of our boat, peering in. Another nice high quality one.
And I have to keep it intact. You never know when you might need it again.
That's sad, but yes, we actually will reuse those.
And
good job. Yeah, progress.
Now we are on our third full day of cruising. We just arrived to Palm Beach yesterday afternoon after making a 40-mile journey from Stuart down here. It took us about 8 hours, and I think we got our anchor down at about 3 p.m., so luckily we still were able to beat the sunset at 5. Today we had big plans to take the boat out the Palm Beach Inlet and go down to Fort Lauderdale. There were some nice east winds, so going that southerly course, we thought we could get the sails up, hopefully ride the counter current of the Gulf Stream, because obviously we don't want to be fighting two knots. But if we picked the counter current, which runs right along shore, we actually could have gotten a one knot push going south, which we were hoping to do. And so we're getting ourselves all ready this morning, getting everything on the boat stowed away to get ready to go outside. And we wake up this morning and find out that the winds are shifting to the south now. So we wouldn't be able to sail it. I don't really want to motor into the winds. We don't want to do all that to try and find a counter current. And so now I think we're just going to sit here in Palm Beach for another day or so. Weather keeps changing. Is really the only spot that it matters is down in this area, because you have the Gulf Stream going from south to north. So you can't sail in any north winds, even though they'd be great to, you know, get you east or south normally. And then if you're trying to go east to the Bahamas, you have the prevailing easterlies, so you don't really want to sail into them. So this is one area where people get kind of stuck a lot, and now we are those people as well. So we're going to keep watching the weather daily. Might have to hang out here for a day or two, but there could be some decent south winds coming in about 2 days. And if that happens, we might, instead of trying to go south and position ourselves near Miami for a crossing, we might just leave here at Palm Beach, because I think we just really want to get to the Bahamas as soon as possible and start enjoying our time there. Since the sun is up and I'm up, I'm going to go make some coffee and relax. How do you feel being ashore again, Georgie?
Yeah, we don't want you to get banned. Banned from the island.
Now we can see Element's parked way out there. After a day of relaxing in an anchorage just south of the inlet, we moved ourselves back to our favorite little spot just east of Peanut Island. This was also good news for Georgie, as we were now a short dinghy ride away from shore and chasing birds and lizards once more.
So I get me back to the boat. So what are we supposed to be saying?
We're leaving.
We're leaving. Normally, to get to Bimini, that's actually where we're going. Normally, what we'd do is we'd go down the coast of Florida till we get out to Miami area, and then when you cross the Gulf Stream, it pushes you a little bit north, but you can kind of angle yourself and arc into Bimini. Now, because of the weather, our plan was to do that, actually, to run down the coast with the typical winds that are coming from the east, run down the coast. Unfortunately, they just haven't quite worked out, so what we're actually going to do now is we are going to go straight out from where we're at, which is in Palm Beach. That should put us towards basically Freeport, Bahamas. And once we cross the stream, Thursday afternoon, right now is Wednesday, around 3 o'clock, Thursday afternoon, we should be able to then turn south, because the winds are gonna start coming out of the east again. And then we can make our south at that point. So right now we're just trying to make our way east, and then we'll hook a right and go south down to Bimini, we hope. If not, we'll end up Barry's, or we'll end up in Nassau or something like that.
I know this may sound like a crazy way, but regardless, we have to spend a day going across the stream or a day going down to Miami.
Yeah.
It takes 2 days anyway, so we're just kind of jamming it all together.
We're going to be doing some motor sailing with the wind circling out of the south right now, and with the stream is fairly strong right now. The Gulf Stream is fairly strong right now with about 2.5 knots, the 3-knot current going north, of course.
where we're going to be motor sailing, which is kind of unfortunate, but we really, a lot of people wait 2 weeks, 3 weeks for weather. We're not going to do that.
No, because once you get across the stream, you can just tack to different places.
Yep. So we can, once we get across the stream, we're fine. It's just getting that direction, getting over there. And once we're in the Bahamian waters, we're on island time then.
Yeah, and we don't care.
No problems, Mon. It's mostly because without it, we're not going to actually point at the Bahamas. We'll point at Bermuda.
Yeah.
And that doesn't quite work.
No. So until the wind shifts more in about 3 or 4 hours, we're kind of stuck doing this. But we're on our way.
Yeah. I'm enjoying myself.
Good. You should, after all your hard work.
We were finally off for the Bahamas with our bow pointed southeast and a course taking us directly east. We knew the Gulf Stream would only strengthen as we sailed toward the center of it, so our actual course through the night was still full of unknowns. We are enjoying our first sunrise sail on Elements. We did end up a little bit further north than we thought. We're actually just about to head into the Little Bahama Bank in the northern Abacos of the Bahamas. Because of the full force of the Gulf Stream, we spent a good few hours in the night with our course 60 degrees north of our heading and found ourselves getting pushed further and further towards the Little Bahama Bank. Deciding not to fight it any longer, we changed our plans to enter through the Abacos instead, excited to see what this new set of islands had in store for us. Join us in our next episode, where we awake in the Little Bahama Banks to find a pod of dolphins coming to say good morning to us, and explore Powell Key in the central Abacos, where we trekked through jungle-like territory to reach a stretch of stunning beach on the other side. Hey guys, I hope you enjoyed this episode with our crossing to the Bahamas. We've got a lot more Bahamian adventures to come, so make sure you hit that subscribe button so you can follow along. And if you like this episode, if you got anything out of it, make sure to give us a thumbs up. Those really help us out. And if you don't do it for us, I was gonna say now she's not here, but I can maybe cut it.
Do it for the Georgie cat.
Do it for the Georgie cat.